Kapurbhaga kept walking, and finally he heard that there was a yogi who would be able to give him this power, and he was called Murpa, the translator. And when he went about the village asking people around if he could meet Murpa, the translator, there was a little boy who came running towards him and said, "Come on, I know someone who can help you." And he took him into a farm where there was a farmer who was plowing his field. And as soon as he saw Kapurbhaga coming, he said, "Just hold this, keep tilling the land until I say." And it was only a few hours, and Kapurbhaga was handed a freshly brewed glass of beer. And after drinking it, he was obviously tired with all the walking in the mountains and valleys. He slept for a while, and then the little boy came. "Hey, why are you sleeping here?" "Man, you said you'll show me Murpa." "That was Murpa. He's my father. I'm his son, you idiot. Just wake up." And the boy was shouting in such a way that Kapurbhaga got up and said, "I'm sorry." He went to the master and said, "Master, I need to learn to get enlightened in this birth, and that is all I seek. I'll do anything." Then Murpa thought for a while and said, "I give you two choices. One, I'll show you, I'll initiate you, I'll give enlightenment. Second thing is you stay out. You get whatever you want, you get food and shelter, you live wherever you want, you come here for classes. And the next thing is, I won't give you any place to stay, or else whatever you're going to do, you have to earn for it." Kapurbhaga thought for a while and said, "It is food and shelter, right? I can take care of it." He went walking, he went struggling, he just worked for days and days. He never slept. He had earned bags and lots of food. He took a cart. He has earned so much and got so much food that he had to take a cart to carry it. And when Kapurbhaga carried it, he felt all the burden in his shoulder. They were even heavier because they were filled not just with goods, it was all the regret he was carrying of killing 85 people. And when he came into Murpa's cottage, he just threw all it with, you know, all the bigger, and it shook the ground. Murpa came out and he said, "You are filled with anger, my boy. I am never going to teach you. Till the land, and then once I think you are free of anger, I'll start teaching you." 13 years went by. 13 years. All he had to do was do the farm work, you know, give water to the hens and chickens and the cows. He was never initiated. Murpa, looking at this boy, he never liked him. He was filled with anger. "I can never take a disciple who is filled with anger. And what if he does wrong things?" This was a thought running in Murpa's mind. What Kapurbhaga did was silently observing. There were batches of students coming in. They could get initiated. They could get enlightened. They'll leave. And observing this, 3 years had passed. And when Kapurbhaga tried getting into the class, sneaking under the house, and he used to be meditating. Murpa, all he did was meditating and teaching. Murpa used to have a bow staff in his hand. While he was meditating, he used to just stand up, take the bow staff, and hit Kapurbhaga in his head and throw him out of the class. This went on for a few other initiations, and then 7 years have passed by. And he had no other choice but to go to Murpa's wife and ask. We know how women are. No, they are light-hearted. They like helping. So he went and asked, "Mother, I have no other go. Don't you see? This is what he had been doing since I came here. It is almost 21 years. I am losing my youth. What is this? I need to live, Mother." And being the kind lady she was, she went and wrote a letter to another master who was of a similar category that Murpa was in. And Kapurbhaga went there and he got initiated, and Murpa got to know this through his vision. He went to that master, got him decertified. And threw back Kapurbhaga into the farm, and he said, "This is what you have to do. It is all bad karma you have been carrying. What else do you expect me to do?" And Kapurbhaga started pleading, "Master, please, don't you see? There are grey hairs now. I came to you as a young man. Please let me do something. What do I need to do to get initiated?" Murpa started thinking for a while and he said, "Build me a 3-cornered castle, and I want to give that to my son. While he was building it with all the effort, he was the only one building the castle. All the work had to be done only by Tobaga. And when it was up to the completion level, Mappa came in and said, "Destroy it. I want a four-walled thing. This, I need four corners for my son. That is going to be right." So he destroyed everything. He built them again. And then he came and said, "I think a five-corner thing would work." And this way he had lost another 8 years. And finally, he was so given up with all this that he wanted to commit suicide. So he went on top of the wall and he said, "Master, I think I'm going to commit suicide. You're not going to teach me anything. This is what I've been doing. I've been toiling for a while now. What is this? Not even a while. See, it's been nearly 25 years, 28 years now. I'm not even counting properly. I'm losing my age." And then Murpa got back to him and said, "Sit down, son. Now I think it's the right time for you to get initiated." And on the third day of his initiation, Tobaga got a vision of a beautiful goddess who was named Dakini. And she said, "There is a technique which even Murpa didn't master himself. And you go, tell Murpa that Dakini told this to you, and I think he'll respond to it." And when Tobaga went and asked Murpa, he was shocked. The goddess had not appeared to him for a long while. It has been nearly 50 years since he started practicing this art, and the goddess had not even come to him. And he was the translator. You know what translators do? In those days, he was someone who traveled to Bihar in India and took all the Sanskrit scriptures and translated them into Tibet. This is what he had been doing. So he said, "My guru is in India. Let's go to India." And he went to his guru and he said, and the guru was shocked. He turned towards the northern side and bowed to the Lordess Dakini. And he said, "I'm sure this didn't happen to you. Why are you telling me this?" And he said, "Master, this didn't happen to me. This was to one of my disciples, Tobaga." And then the master bowed down to Tobaga and he taught him all the lessons, the tantric secrets and the way to get enlightened in this lifetime. And Tobaga became the great saint Milarepa, which means the one with cotton robes. He was so soft that even the cotton around him was, you know, lightning. He was so soft. And he had written thousands of poems about Tibetan Buddhism, and he is now the idol of Tibetan Buddhism. So let us all think about this story as something motivating, and then a drive which will, you know, get past all the regrets. I'm not sure if we can learn tantric secrets, but we can get past the regrets we have. Thank you.